Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? For our next performance, please be advised that what you are about to witness has not been prearranged. No one in tonight's audience is an actor or a plant. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Star Night. The tools of a great realtor, some of them, market knowledge, psychology, persuasion, and a deep, deep understanding of human nature. Coincidentally, these are the identical attributes of a professional mentalist, a mind reader. I know, I agree. For tonight's demonstration, I'd like to talk to you about the perfect house, the ideal house, something that all of us, I think, can relate to. Matching people with houses is truly an art form, and many of you here tonight are the masters of your craft. Your success is defined as a meeting of the minds. But here's something to think about, something to consider. Who truly influences whom when it comes to buying a home? In other words, do we as realtors really nudge our clients to choose a very specific home? Or are there other forces at play? So tonight I've designed an experiment to explore that mysterious side of real estate, to turn the tables a bit, and hopefully understand the power of influence in the buying process. I'm going to need a volunteer at this time, and I'm going to need a female. Let's face it, who makes the decision when buying a home? Give it up. I'm going to be throwing this frisbee somewhere out to the right side of the audience, and I need for a woman to please catch it. I can't see where I'm going to be throwing this. We'll turn the lights up just slightly. Please catch it. When you do, please make your way to this center aisle. My assistant Holly has a flashlight here. Holly is walking over. She's going to bring you up on the stage. We're going to go right now. Please catch this frisbee. Hopefully I can throw it up. Pretty good. Female, please. Grab it, and it looks like we have a volunteer. Do we? I can't see. Yes. Come on up. Thank you very much. And would you... I can't see who's here, but it sounds exciting. They all know you. Would you... Would you just stand over here, and Holly, just stand here for a moment? You've got my Angry Bird Frisbee. Thank you. Just stay here for a moment. Good evening. My name is Brett, and nope, we're not going to play Frisbee. It's okay. What is your name, please?
Jan Cabani.
Jan, thank you so much. Jan, would you just please verify so everyone here knows this is not prearranged and you are not part of the show. Is that
definitely
accurate?
Definitely not prearranged.
All right. All right, Jan, would everyone give Jan a big round of applause, please, for our spectator? Yes. And you guys can just step over here for a moment. I need to set things up here just a little bit before we bring Jan up. So you can stand here for a moment. I want to tell you guys a story. It's actually a true story, one of my favorites, about a client of mine about 9 or 10 years ago. Her name was Sidel, and she was the youngest 85-year-old that I'd ever met. She was a ball of fire, full of life. Anything that was in her head would immediately come out of her mouth. She was just a character. When I first met Sidel, she explained to me that Raymond, her husband of over 60 years, had recently died in his sleep after a long battle with brain cancer. She said that she had found him one morning upon waking up, calm and motionless. She looked down at him and frantically tried to shake him and to wake him up, but he would not wake up. In fact, she went into so much detail about how he had died to me, and people do this sometimes as realtors, that I could tell two things immediately. One was that Raymond was the love of her life. And two, I could tell that she hadn't really had a chance to express herself to anyone else because she didn't have any other family in the area. And then we talked about why she had called me, and she said that she could, of course, no longer live in their house. It was time for a change. And she said her only stipulation was that the house had to feel right. So we looked at houses for weeks and weeks, months, actually. And I could tell within seconds, usually, that the house wasn't right. One day we pulled up to a house in the Roosevelt District, and it didn't seem that remarkable from the outside. But as soon as we walked inside, something changed. She was immediately drawn to this gorgeous carved oak fireplace in the living room. It was almost like a piece of furniture. She went right up to it, and she just stood there looking at this beautiful piece of carving. And she reached her hand as high as she could and ran it along the top of the mantle. And it almost seemed like she felt something at the top. And then she pulled something out. A dusty black and white photo. It showed a 1930s couple playfully kissing. And it had probably not seen the light of day in over 70 or 80 years. I looked directly at Sidel, and I noticed a single tear running down her cheek. "Are you okay?" I asked her. She held her mouth and she said, "Honey, this photo looks so much like Raymond and I when we were first dating." And then she said those three magic words that we all love to hear. "This is it." She bought the house. Well, about a month after the sale, I got a call from Sidel. She invited me for a cup of coffee. Some small talk, chit-chat about the house. She loved it. And then she said, "Brett, I've got a gift for you." She reached into her little pink handbag, and what did she pull out but that beautiful photo of the couple kissing with a little red ribbon around it and an inscription on the back. And she said, "Brett, I want you to keep this photo as a reminder that houses are a connection to people that we love." I've received a lot of gifts over the years, 20 years in real estate, but that was by far the most beautiful gift that I've ever received. Often I've wondered to myself whether Sidel chose that old house, or did that old house choose Sidel? Perhaps tonight we'll get a little closer to finding out the power of influence. Time to begin our experiment. I've only had clients like Sidel.
All right.
Here's how it's going to work tonight, our experiment. I'm going to ask you to play the part of the realtor, Jan.
Okay?
Just go with me here.
Okay.
I'm going to play the part of the customer. Your job is to hopefully find my perfect house for me. My job is to influence you in some very subtle ways that customers do. Now, we need a location first. So before tonight's show, we asked more than, gosh, how many people do we have in the audience tonight? More than 600 or 700 of you. We asked actually 60 of you to write down a city or state that was meaningful. And we put them in these little pieces of paper into this plastic bag. Would you do me a favor? By the way, audience, by a raise of hands, if you participated tonight and put a city and state in this bag, would you please raise your hand so we can see? Looks like we have a fair number of people here. Raise your hands, keep them up. Okay, we have about 60 people. Would you take about three and just verify that they are different? And yep, different colors, that's good. Stick with the different colors. And then if you could just read them out loud, and Holly, my assistant, is gonna hold that up. Just read it. What do we have?
Lynchenbald, Texas.
Okay.
Phoenix, Arizona.
Perfect.
And Madison, Wisconsin.
Excellent. Let's put them back in. If you could just fold them up individually, and we'll put them back so they can be part of the mix. And I want you to be drawn to one of these that you feel attracted to. I'm going to close this up. Give it a nice shake here. Would you do me a favor, please, and just take one? Thank you. Okay. And if you would read it out loud, that is going to be our destination this evening.
Lubbock, Texas.
Lubbock, Texas. Is anyone from Lubbock? Someone must be from Lubbock here. All right. Excellent. We have a house here. We're going to, you can see it's a fixer-upper, Jan, so okay. You're going to help me fix it up, okay? And I'll take that from you. And come on over here. Would you do me a favor, Jan, and write Lubbock, Texas here? That's going to help us hone in like GPS on the location. Nice and big, Lubbock. I don't even know how to spell that. I think there's two B's in that. O-C-K. Very good, perfect. All right, excellent. All right, would you have a seat here, please? And just move your chair just a little bit closer. Excellent. Now, what we're going to do now is we've got to paint this house. It's a fixer-upper. What I'm going to do now is I am going to be blindfolded. I'm not going to be able to see what's happening at all. And as a customer, I am going to ask you to start painting the house. Here's how it's going to work. Christine, my assistant here, has a cup with some markers. When I tell you to, not before, take one single color out, and then I'll tell you what to do with it. If you would, please take a color. Okay, and with that one, can you fill in just the front door of the house, please? Front door only. With that marker, yes, please. And when you're done, you can give the marker back to Christine. We won't use it again. I like this music, too. Perfect. Good job, Jan. All right, take another color. Okay, with that one, would you fill in just the chimney, please, Jan? We are fixing up our fixer-upper. This is going to be a gorgeous house. It's going to be a PV special tonight. Multiple offer situation coming on this house. Oh, yeah. You go, Jan. All right, can we take another color? Tell me when you have it. Okay. With that one, you fill in the windows, please. Just fill in the windows. House should be looking gorgeous by now. I'm excited. And when you're done, just give the pen to Christine. Take another color. Okay. With that one, could you fill in the roof of the house, please? Roof only. Take another color. Okay. And with that one, can you fill in the body of the house, please? How many colors do we have left? Do we have anything left? That's the last one? Okay, and maybe put some smoke on top of the chimney, the puffs of smoke. All right, are we ready? Okay, I want to take a look at this beautiful house here. Okay, cool. All right, so we've got, if you would just stand up here for a moment, please. All right, and I'm gonna stand right next to you. So we have a location of Lubbock, Texas. We have all the various colors. Beautiful job here, by the way. Now remember before, Jan, I said I had a perfect house in mind. My perfect house is right here. I was hoping to influence you in a few ways. We'll see how close. It may not be exact, but let's see how I did. You move the chair here. Stand back just slightly so everybody can see. Let's see. You have an orange door with purple. You have green on the windows. I have green as well. Go on up. Looks like we're a little off on the roof, and we have a perfect match on the chimney as well. I mean, did you feel like you were influenced in some way? Thank you. But you know what? In real estate, Jan, it's all about location, isn't it? Right? Location, location. Do me a favor, if you would, just stand right here, and I'm going to stand here. Now, before we started tonight, I brought something with me, something that was very sentimental. I actually brought that picture of the couple kissing, the one that we can see up here on the screen. And I brought that with me because It meant a great deal to me. Would you do me a favor and just, it's actually hiding right here. You can see it. Just take a look at it. Don't say anything. And you're going to come over. Just, you could just take a look here. It's a beautiful picture from the 1930s. That's the one Sydell gave me. When Sydell first gave me that picture, she wrote an inscription on the back, something that meant something to her. I didn't tell you what she wrote. Sydell actually wrote the city and state where she and Raymond were married in 1937. Take a look at the back, and would you please read loudly what is written on the back here?
Lubbock, Texas.
The perfect house, ladies and gentlemen. You give a hand to Jan. Thank you very much. She'll take you off the stage. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
Good job.
Thank you.
Tonight, I'm a mentalist, and I wanted to try and do something special for all of you tonight. My job is to use influence to try and either get information or to try and project information, all right? And I'd like someone to help me, and I was thinking, Amy, would you mind helping
sure.
me?
All right.
Please, everyone give a hand to Amy once again.
Thank you.
Now, Amy, we have not pre-rehearsed anything. I'm not talking about anything. We just met for the first time, correct? Okay, excellent. Do you need to wear glasses, or are you able to see if I show you a book or something like that?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Now, we were talking a little bit tonight about influence. And there's certain words that people think of automatically. Like if I ask you to think of a word, just bam. A lot of people think of words like tree, house, dog, these types of very obvious words. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
I want you to think of a very random word. So I've actually brought a book here, one of the Jack Reacher books. Have you guys
seen? I love Jack Reacher.
I love Jack Reacher too.
Love it.
All right, I brought the Jack Reacher book here, Killing Floor. And I'm going to give you this envelope here. Stand over here if you would so everybody just turns towards me. The light's a little bit better. But you just hold this envelope, but you're going to keep it, and we're not going to look at it yet, okay? Now, a book contains hundreds of thousands of words. Does that make sense? Lots of words here. And this book has any number of words that you can choose. I'm going to use this playing card, and I'd like you to just to tell me when to stop, and you can stop me wherever you'd like, okay? You want to stop here or do you want to go somewhere else?
There.
Okay. I'm going to ask you to look at the first word in the upper left corner. First word in the left corner of the page. Take a look at it and remember what that word is. Do you remember what it is? First word and remember the page number. Have you got it? And the page number?
Yeah.
Okay, great. All right. Take the book if you would, please. And I'm going to try and discern what that word is, okay? So let me look at you for a moment. Perfect. Think about the word and think about what it means, okay? Okay, good. All right. I'm thinking this is a word that is a kind of a positive word. Does that make sense? It's more positive than negative. Okay, good. And let me try and think of the last letter. Almost see the letters on a big white movie screen. The last letter I'm getting. A T, does that make sense to you? Last letter of the word. You know what? No, it's okay. It's okay. A D.
Yeah.
It's a D. Okay. No, this, I've got a D. Good. I've just got to make that connection here. It's a D. Okay. Go to the first letter, please. Okay. You're getting a little ahead of me, I think. Go to the first letter. Okay. I'll let you all see what I'm writing here. The first letter, what is the first letter of the word, please? What letter did I write here?
Yes.
Perfect. Now, I'm going to be honest with you right now. I think we've made a connection. I think I know what word you're thinking of, and there's a reason for that. Remember I said earlier, a lot of what I do is based on influence. And there was a word that I was hoping to influence you to see in a very interesting way. Now, I'm going to put this away. No mumbo jumbo, we're just going to go right to it. I think you've connected now and I think you've got the word in mind. I want you to just, on the count of three, we're going to say the word together, okay?
Okay.
And we can't go ahead of each other, so just like kids, so we'll do it at the same time here.
Okay.
All right? One, two, three. Stretched. Stretched. That was your word. Yes. You could have chosen any word. That's the word in your mind. Fascinating. Do you remember the page number you saw that word on?
Yes.
Can you do me a favor, please, Amy, and find that word, please, on that page? You've got the page number. Page isn't there. Now, I've got something to tell you.
Oh.
That page was never there. I took that page out before we started tonight, interestingly enough. Are you confident that you saw, what was the page number that you believe you saw?
294. Yes.
All right. And that page, you don't see it there. And you saw the word stretch on that page. Interesting. You've been holding that envelope the entire time. Now, remember I said that I've been trying to influence you.
Okay.
That's what I do.
No way.
I don't know if you noticed this, Amy, but the light's a little bit low. There are some numbers. What was the page number that you saw, you believe you saw?
200.
There's a little number on each corner of the envelope. You've held this the whole time. And the word stretched, do you notice what's right here on the front of the envelope? A rubber band, which of course typically stretches. But here's where things may get a little bit crazy. Look inside the envelope. Could you do me a favor and just fold the book open to the ripped out page? This is kind of like Cinderella.
It's 294.
Is the word there?
Right.
And let's take a look and make sure that the page fits. And it fits perfectly. Would you give a big hand to Amy? Thank you very much. Thank you very, very much. I just want to thank you all. I'm going to be here for probably at least another half hour. Has everyone had a great time?
Yeah.
My pleasure. Have fun and enjoy the party.
Thank you.